He told her she didn't have to.
So there was a very small part of McLaren engineering in that
question comes from a friend of the pod, Rick Benton, who joined us earlier in the series to look back at the 1993 race at Dunton Park. His question asks, aside from Matt Neal, who do you think was the best of the independents throughout the same tournament era? So I think this is what we can all have a stab at answering. Greg, should I come to you first? Independents, apart from Matt Neal, who sticks out in your mind?
It's a tricky question. I think, well, I'll have to say the one who came into my mind first of all, and that's Tommy Rushko, who did have a brief battery drive, didn't he, in that Renault Laguna, famously at Silverstone at the end of that season with Aluminium and a ride. Right, the man, he didn't be I think Tommy Rushko, although there's a few of them, I'm trying to think now. Obviously, Rob Gravett was a top independent at one point. Lee Brooks was a handy driver who would have been good to see, I think, in a factory car. But I'd have to go. Yeah, apart from that deal, I'm going to go for Tommy Rushton.
Adam, come to you, what do you have in your mind from that era?
Yeah, you got Rushton. I mean, McKay's, that's probably
it.
James Kay. That's what had come to my mind initially, James Kay.
Yeah, for me, Richard, his brother, was great as well.
Yeah, so McKay came to my mind, and then obviously you've got a lot of Rushton, like Greg just said, so chuck one really.
Chris Goodwin. Chris Goodwin.
People could have gone, haven't they?
I'm trying to think of like who won in like a really particularly old car. You know, Matt Neal would obviously have a year old Nissan, Rushton had a year old Laguna. Did anyone have a standout performance as an independent in a really old chassis?
I remember Jamie Ward doing well at a very old Cavalier in 97 in a car that was well over 2 years old.
And it was all distributed sort of wrong at the bottom, wasn't it? I remember Charlie Cox did a feature on the 97 review of the grandstand. Everything was
that's
sort of
right.
Place, wasn't
that's
it?
That's right, they had the Vauxhall team there, didn't they? Saying, if you do to this, you know, that's not quite right, that's not quite right.
Yeah.
And then he's like, no, it was 70 grand, is it?
Yeah.
But yeah, they're looking through some of the early ones. Chris Goodwin, there was the deserves a bit more, deserved a chance. Richard Kay was like,
Adam, on etc. I was Tarquini, the exception to the rule and the only one to really shine.
I don't know why Tarquini was the only one to shine, but as a general rule, I'm just looking at the disciplines are so different. You know, you look at, obviously, Wydell came into it, did really well. His background was single seaters. Calvin Burt, he came in a bit, his background was single seaters. So it's one of those paths that, as a youngster, when you go from karting, you either choose single seaters or you go tin tops. Obviously, you know, most want to go single seaters, but there's very rarely start their careers as a tin top driver. Probably Fiestas back then. Obviously, then it obviously changed to clear up and up. So you go one way or the other. The only thing I can bring down to is discipline is just completely different. You know, you've gone from being absolutely your backside's on the floor, loads of downforce, loads of grip, loads of power, speed, lighter cars, and then obviously in a bigger car that handles in a completely different way. You've gone from rear wheel drive to front wheel drive, the engine's the other end of the car, you're sat in a different position. Yeah, it's just so many different things, and that's the only thing you can bring down to, really. Obviously Tarquini came in a completely gnarly, but I think his career was predominantly, you know, single seats one, but then he had a very long career in the touring cars and was very successful at it, just like Wydell. You know, but most of them that you would find, like I said, one, but most of the drivers that were on that grid at some point came from single seaters. Obviously you've highlighted the fact that we're talking Formula 1 drivers here, but yeah, I think it's just coming from something so different, it's hard to get there around.
Greg, coming to you now. Roden Junior Hill has written in to say, top work in Series 4, thoroughly enjoyed every episode. Amazing that you managed to get James Thompson off for a pod. Which driver/drivers would you have liked to see in period race in the championship but never did?
That's such a difficult question, isn't it? I saw that on the script when I had a quick speak a few minutes ago. It's a really tricky question. Alan Cross is somebody whose name has come up in previous episodes of this show, who I didn't.